tuko na wageni wetu hapa, Dan Oreri wa CDF. Dan, yuko wapi? Hapa, mheshimiwa Miguel Diambo. Pia tuko na Lavenda Ojala Nyagwasi. Pale uliko, ebu inua mkono, Lavenda. Huyo ndiye Lavenda Nyagwasi. Na pia tuko na Sylvia Opondo kutoka ofisi ya governor wa Siaya. Sylvia, yuko wapi? Aliwa vizuri na mheshimiwa mbunge wa hapa.
Churches have spoken very boldly about the war against corruption. In fact, they have taken the ball back to President Uhuru's court that he should tackle corruption without fear or favor. I want to appeal to President Uhuru Kenyatta now that he has the support of Raila Odinga, who is speaking without contradiction and in full commitment in the war against corruption, that he should not be weak-kneed. And I want to say this without fear of contradiction, the people that Uhuru is taking to court, Haji and the Lord, these are small people. They are afraid of the big fish. We want to see the big fish in court. In Korea, they went for the president of the Republic of Korea, a lady who came here, and she ended up being in jail. In Malaysia, they went for the prime minister. So, President Uhuru Kenyatta, we all know you're serious about the war against corruption when you begin from the top. And the charge was saying, begin from the top. The dams. What have you done about the issue of the dams? I know Haji has said, you know, it's going to take a long time. The investigations are very complicated. Don't talk until you have had incredible evidence that can bring about conviction. So, President Uhuru Kenyatta, I know Raila is behind you 100%, but begin from the top. Because he said you'll not spare even your own brother. Lastly, President Uhuru Kenyatta and Raila Odinga have said we are going to bring change to the country called Kenya. And President Uhuru Kenyatta has only 3 years. He must act with haste, because within the 3 years we have a census, we have a referendum, and we have elections. And to undertake these three national projects, he must act in haste and systematically and sequentially. We want to know how these things are going to follow each other. Census, we know the plan. Referendum, there must be a time frame that we know we are going to have a referendum in good time. And of course, the general elections must come after we have amended the constitution. I want to repeat, President Uhuru Kenyatta usiye mwoga. Wakenya wamekubali vita dhidi ya corruption. Na Raila Odinga amekubali kukupatia uwezo. Kisha wanasimama wanasema huu mheshimiwa mwambie afanye kazi. Sisi tunataka Auditor General aingie kule Ganze, yeye mwenyewe alijionee maneno yalivyo, na kama bunge waweze kusaidia huyu mheshimiwa mwambie ambaye ameingia juzi kupitia chama cha ODM aweze kufanyia watu wake kazi. Mheshimiwa Odinga amezungumza hapa kuhusu masuala ya upinzani. Mimi ninashangaa kila siku mheshimiwa Uhuru Kenyatta, huyu ndiye uko na support ya walimu, uko na support ya makanisa, uko na support ya vyama vyote vya ODM, vyama vyote vya Kenya ikiwemo ODM. Wale wanapinga vita dhidi ya ufisadi ni hao wachache tu wakieleweke. Tunashindwa ni kwa nini hauwezi kuvimaliza hivi vita dhidi ya ufisadi. Tunaunga kanisa, tunasema kwamba tunaona moto umepungua. Wezi wamekuwa bora kwa sababu wanaona hakuna kitu mbaya inafanyika kwao. Tunataka kuona yule mkuu wa ukurasa ungenyanyi mwenyewe akishika. Biblia ambayo umenipatia hapa inasema ukimtwanga mchungaji wa kondoo, kondoo wa kundi lake watatawanyika. Wacha hii maneno, tunaona wanaenda kushika watu wadogo KRA. Shika yule high priest wa ukurasa mwenyewe na anajulikana. Hii mambo ya ufisadi itaisha Kenya. Na inavunja moyo sana wakati wa Kenya wamekasirika kuhusu mambo ya ufisadi. wanaenda kuandamana kule kwa barabara, unaona huyu inspector general wa polisi mpya anapiga wao shaga. Hiyo shaga zinatakana ipigwe kwa ofisi na serikali ili ofisaji wa kule hiyo shaga. We are committed to fighting corruption. In fact, that is one of the very fundamental reasons that we support the handshake. With corruption endemic as it is, we are unlikely to get development. My brothers and colleagues have talked about corruption at the national level. I want to talk about corruption at the county level. In fact, as the president continues to pursue the big fish, we want the president to come to the counties and deal with the corrupt county officials. We want lifestyle audits to be done to all governors and to all executive officers of the county, because this is where
corruption must deal decisively with corruption. My senior Senator Wengo has called on the president to deal with corruption with boldness and firmness and without weakness of the knee. I want to call upon the DPP, I want to call upon the DCI and ESCC, that corruption shall not be fought on social media. Corruption will only be fought and won when we see people being taken before the courts of law and we see convictions. That is when people will be made afraid of stealing public resources. To be honest, in this republic, today as we speak, there is no other former governor who has been taken before the courts of law except Evans Kidero. We do not want selective application of the law and selective prosecution. The Auditor General has generated enough reports that show the kind of loot and sleaze and theft going on in the counties. We want to see the ESCC bringing cases, the DPP bringing cases to deal with those people who are stealing from us, from the funds that have been devoted to them. Number two on corruption, I want to tell the governors of this republic, because I saw Oparanya, the chair of Council of Governors, telling them not to come before the Senate. The same Council of Governors wants the Senate to give them more money. Indeed, as Senate, we have approved that counties should get 333 billion as opposed to the 310 billion offered by the Treasury. If you want us to give you more money, then you must be ready to account for that money. I want to tell Oparanya, choose your battles carefully. You either choose the battle of getting more money, or you choose the battle of not cooperating with the Senate. On Monday, we have called Governor for Migori, Okoko-Bado, to appear before Senate. Okoko-Bado, usipokuja, utabeba msalaba wako. Hautasaidiwa na Oparanya. On Tuesday, we have called Sipia Naweti, Achidawuz, Ojewa Lake Council. I want to tell Sipia Naweti, if you do not show up, you shall carry your own cross. Oparanya will not be there to help you carry your own cross. Kila governor lazima kuwa accountable individually. The Council of Governors is a stranger to public audit matters. And I want to tell the Council of Governors to allow the Senate to do its job in accordance with its calendar.
Anybody who supports the handshake must support the DPI. Anybody who supports DPI must support the report that they will produce. And in all logic, that report must include finishing corruption in this country. That report must include jailing the thieves, including the chief thief. What do you mean chief thief? When the time comes,